Hello there! On this video I'm going to show you how to create bullet journal printables using your iPad in the application Pages. Alright, let's get started! So the first thing you're going to do is choose a pattern paper or wallpaper that you want for your bullet journal. This is the one that I'm going to use in this video or in this tutorial. I prefer dots than any other type of paper. I'm going to save it, and I prefer saving it in Dropbox. So I have one there. There you go. Now that we have it saved, let's go with our iPad. Go to Pages. And these are some of the printables that I was working on, but now we're gonna start with a brand new one. So we're gonna create a new document, blank page. Okay, and now we're gonna change the background. So we're gonna click the three dots, scroll down a little, document setup, and I'm going to just stretch it a little bit to have some room. And this is how we're gonna add our background. You're going to click in the add and the little cross at the top, insert from. And then you're going to look for the folder where you save your printable. I save mine in Dropbox. Okay, I'm going to choose this one. And you can see it in the front here. So what we're going to do is just stretch it just to the lines of where your printable, of where your, of the ends, at the end of this, right here. Because we're going to add a border. So now that it's selected, we're gonna click here, style, border. And you can choose any type of border you want. They have a lot to choose from. I'm just going to use this one, the plain and simple one. I'm gonna select go, make sure it's right on the page. It looks neat and everything. Once you're happy with the way it looks, you're just gonna click done. There we go. That's how you're gonna look. And you can see that nothing moves, the background stays. Now we're gonna add our title. Click the screen and then we're gonna type something. Let's see, let's create a weekly layout. It's weekly to do. Select it, gonna click here, and we're gonna play with the font. Choose one that you like. I like this one, and then I like putting it in the center. Gonna make it a little bit, not too big. I think I like the way it looks. Alright. Let's put this one back to the side, and then we're gonna, I usually like making blank lines, and I like to fill it in with the name of my classes. It's just easier for me, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm using an external keyboard, but if you click here and another click, that's how you get the lines. But since this one is a little too big, we're going to reduce the size of the font. There we go. Let's put her right there. Okay. And now I'm going to add bullets. So I'm going to click the little paintbrush, bullets. And I'm gonna choose the big bullet. And if you want to add more bullets, the only thing that you have to do is just put a dot, enter, dot, enter, dot, enter, until you're happy with how many bullets you have, and then just delete the periods. Okay, I think this one is two to the side, so I'm going to move it. And I'm using the fat bar on my external keyboard. And now I'm going to add another one in the center and another one to the right. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to copy this whole thing. Click the plus sign and we're going to add a new text right there. So I'm going to see how if I place it around, it's just going to move my layout. So this is how we're going to fix it. You're going to select, make sure it's selected, click the paintbrush and click where it says none. There we go. Now you can move it around and it won't disturb your layout. So we're going to click on the center of it, double tap, click paste and just fix the layout. There we go. I'm just going to make sure it's in line with the other one. Okay, and I'm going to copy this one and paste it on the side. There we go. I like that Pages gives you the lines or the ruler to make sure you're putting everything in the right place or everything is symmetrical. Okay, so this is how it looks. And I think I'm gonna add, notes at the bottom. So to delete the bullets, just click the paintbrush, bullets, none. There we go. Now I'm gonna put notes, make it a little bit bigger. Paintbrush. And you just have to play a little bit with it until you, it's kind of the style you want. Okay. There we go. Now, this is how we're gonna, if you like a simple, that's cool, but I like it when it has drawings or images on the background. So what I'm gonna do is go to the folder where I have all my digital stickers, choose the ones that I want. So I'm going to choose Christmas and these are all the ones that I have, and we're going to save them as images. So I'm going to choose this one. Click here, save image, and choose another one. If you're wondering where I got all these digital stickers, I'm going to link it in the description box. You just have to wait for some of them to load. Okay. Okay, so we'll go back to Pages, and this is what we're gonna do. Click the plus button or plus at the top, select images and all photos, and we're gonna choose the boot. Just resize it, and see how our boot is also messing up with our layout. We're gonna do the same thing as before. Click here to the side and arrange, none, and now you can just put it anywhere. Okay, this is how it looks. I just put a bunch of digital stickers to show you how to accomplish that. So now, here's a cool trick. If you wanna, if you don't want just the plain simple bullets, you can install an application called Psyche, and then you can just customize the keyboard to any type you want. I have this one for my science classes, and to the very back I have all my bullet journals and things like that. I have like a heart, squares, dashes, anything you want. You just make sure you click save. So yeah, and that's what you can do here. Instead of having in your notes boring bullets, we can just add the cool bullets. Okay, we're going to export it as PDF. Click at the dot, send copy, PDF. And I love saving everything in Dropbox. I'm going to save it in Dropbox. You can rename it. So I'm gonna name it Bullet Journal Layout Draft. Dropbox, save. Okay, so now you can use it with any of your favorite applications on your iPad. My favorite is Notability, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna show you. This one is my digital bullet journal, and these are some of the examples that I've done with my digital bullet journal, some books, the movies I'm watching. So here, I'm going to export it. Open it. And there we go. This is how it looks. You can see how high quality the stickers look, the background, the notes. I just love how it looks very neat, very elegant. So let's write on it. I like to color code my classes. I'm going to put my genetics back into purple and my medical botany into green.